Rick Edberg, the founding artistic director of the Greencastle Summer Music Festival, which has now morphed into the Greencastle Virtual Music Festival. We present a pre-recorded program that debuts at 7:30 p.m. Eastern Time every Wednesday night. If you are watching when that program debuts on Facebook and YouTube, you can also go to gvmf.live. That takes you to a Zoom room where a number of us watch together, and then we have a post-concert discussion with each other and with the performers. It's a great time of connecting with each other, something that's so important to our mental, emotional, and spiritual health while we're distant from each other during the coronavirus pandemic. We open tonight, as we usually do, with the wonderful four cello arrangement by Sedona, Arizona's Avery Waite of Chuck Berry's No Particular Place to Go. And I have no particular place to go. And other than to be with you, I do want to let you know that unlike most of our variety shows, tonight is actually a service in the Christian, especially the Anglican tradition. If you are of the Christian faith, you are welcome to experience this as a worship service. If you're not, you're welcome to enjoy this as a beautiful program of music and poetry, including readings from the Hebrew and Christian scriptures, and also contemporary poetry. So we're just happy to have you here in whatever way you want to participate. You may also want to get yourself a candle for the singing of Silent Night later on when we're going to dim the lights, or certainly you can dim your own lights. Tonight's program has a program. It's service festival of lessons and carols. Go on over to, while I'm telling you about the program, go to lessonsandcarols.gvmf.live, and there's a 12-page PDF program that Suzanne Hassler put together with great love and meticulousness, and you'll find it very helpful if you print that out or have it open as we go through the show, or service, not really a show. Lessons and Carols goes back to 1880 in Cornwall, England. Christmas was a primarily secular celebration with them. Had a lot of, you know, people going and singing Christmas carols, which often were secular in nature at each other's homes. A lot of drinking. The bishop was a little bit fed up. He wanted to get his parishioners out of the pubs and into the church on Christmas Eve, believe it or not. And came up with this idea of combining Bible readings and Christmas carols. And it was just kind of a new phenomenon in the late 19th century in England to have Christmas carols sung in church. Well, 400 people showed up on Christmas Eve in 1880, and the rest is history. Lessons and Carols became really very, very well known because of the annual performance or presentation of it at King's College in Cambridge, England, which has been broadcast all over the world, and the tradition has been adopted and adapted all over the world. It was certainly going strong when I came to Greencastle in 1988, where DePauw School of Music choirs put it on every year at Goeben Church. More recently, it's been done at St. Andrew's Episcopal Church. Now, almost nowhere are there live services this year, and some of our recent School of Music alumni got the idea to create a virtual Lessons and Carols, and what a labor of love it has been. Anna Louise Martin has served as the executive producer, Blake Beckemeyer as the music director. Blake conducted to Amanda Hobson of the School of Music, playing the piano, sent that out to the singers, who each recorded themselves, who sent their videos to Anna, who put them together. It's just amazing kind of mosaic or jigsaw puzzle that has gone on, and they have done a wonderful job. Our singers tonight are Shannon Berry and Anna Louise Martin, sopranos, Blake Beckemeyer and Will Upham, tenors, and Simon Lee, bass. They just do a fantastic job. They, along with Suzanne Hassler, recruited various readers from Greencastle, a lot of School of Music faculty and retired faculty, the new School of Music dean, Kay Hoke, Suzanne herself. So that is really quite something. I think I've said everything I need to say. Our officiants, Religious leaders tonight are Sue Murray of St. Andrew's Episcopal Church, where she's the senior warden, and Chaplain Beth Newton Watson of the DePauw Center for Spiritual Life. The service, program, concert, whatever you call it, takes about 50 minutes. I'll be back at the end to invite you to the conversation after the concert and also tell you about what's coming up in future weeks. But now, I hope you got your program ready, got that candle ready for Silent Night, and we start off in the sanctuary of the beautiful St. Andrew's Episcopal Church right here in Greencastle, Indiana.
We have come together as the family of God in our Father's presence to celebrate the great festival of Christmas. In this service, we hear and receive the good news of the birth of Christ, and we offer to God our thanksgiving in the joyful singing of carols. As we gather together in the name of Christ, we pray for the world he came to save, for the church that it may be enabled in our generation to surrender anew to God's holy wisdom and bear the good news of God's love to a needy world, for the world which is already Christ's, that all its people may recognize their responsibility for its future and may be inspired by the message of Christmas to work together for the establishment of justice, freedom, and peace everywhere. For all in special need, the sick, the anxious, the lonely, the fearful, and the bereaved, that the peace and the light of the Christ child may bring hope and healing to all who sit in darkness. We commend all whom we love or who have asked for our prayers to the unfailing mercy of our Heavenly Father, and say together, as Christ himself taught us, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Let us hear and heed in Holy Scripture the story of God's loving purpose from the time of our rebellion against him until the glorious redemption brought to us by his holy child Jesus. And let us remember his birth with hymns and songs of praise.
With the poor and the needy. A reading from the book of Genesis, chapter 3, verses 8 through 15 and 17 through 19. The man and his wife heard the sound of the Lord God walking in the garden at the time of the evening breeze, and they hid themselves from the presence of Lord God among the trees of the garden. But the Lord God called to the man and said to him, "Where are you?" He said, "I heard the sound of you in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked and I hid myself." He said, "Who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten from the tree of which I commanded you not to eat?" The man said, "The woman whom you gave me to be with, she gave me fruit from the tree and I ate." Then the Lord God said to the woman, "What is this that you have done?" The woman said, "The serpent tricked me and I ate." The Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, cursed are you among all animals and among all wild creatures. Upon your belly you shall go, and dust you shall eat all the days of your life. I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your offspring and hers. He will strike your head, and you will strike his heel." And to the man he said, "Because you have listened to the voice of your wife, and have eaten of the tree about which I commanded you, you shall not eat of. Cursed is the ground because of you. In toil you shall eat of it all the days of your life. Thorns and thistles it shall bring forth for you, and you shall eat the plants of the field. By the sweat of your face you shall eat bread until you return to the ground, for out of it you were taken. You are dust, and to dust you shall return."
The tree of life my soul has seen, laden with
oh.
This food doth make my soul delight.
The angel of the Lord called to Abraham a second time from heaven and said, "By myself I have sworn, declares the Lord. Because you have done this and have not withheld your son, your only son, I surely will bless you. And I will surely multiply your offspring as the stars of heaven and as the sand that is on the seashore. And your offspring shall possess the gate of his enemies. And in your offspring shall all the nations of the earth be blessed, because you have obeyed my voice."
The old tradition says at Christ's born there was utter silence. The whole created world was still. For an hour, even choirs of angels went quiet. It seems fitting, in the infant face of incomprehensibility, to forego language, sound, even song, and to still enact that tiny spark, the word, dropped into kindling flesh, set afire everything we thought we knew about God.
Thank you. The prophet foretells the coming of the Savior. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders. And he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this.
Saith our God, comfort those who sit in darkness, mourning 'neath their sorrows, Lord. Speak ye to Jerusalem of the peace that waits for them. Tell her that her sins I cover, and her warfare now is over. For the herald's voice is crying in the desert far and near, bidding all men to repentance, since the kingdom now is here.
Shall come forth a rod out of the stem of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. And the Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and of the fear of the Lord, and shall make him of quick understanding in the fear of the Lord. With righteousness shall he judge the poor, and reprove with equity for the meek of the earth. The wolf also shall dwell with the lamb, and the leopard shall lie down with the kid, and the calf and the young lion and the fatling together, and a little child shall lead them. And the cow and the bear shall feed, their young one shall lie down together, and the lion shall eat straw like the ox. And the suckling child shall play on the hole of the asp, and the weaned child shall put his hand on the cockatrice's den. They shall not hurt nor destroy in all my holy mountain, for the earth shall be full of the knowledge of the Lord as the waters cover the sea.
Seek, O Jesus,
Oh, This was the moment when before turned into after, and the future's uninvented timekeepers presented arms. This was the moment when nothing happened. Only dull peace sprawled boringly over the earth. This was the moment when even energetic Romans could find nothing better to do than counting heads in remote provinces. And this was the moment when a few farm workers and three members of an obscure Persian sect walked haphazard by starlight straight into the kingdom of heaven.
A reading from Luke, chapter 1. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. And he will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her.
Magnificat anima mea Dominum, et exultavit spiritus meus in Deus salutari meo, qui a respexit humilitatem ancile sue, ecce enim ex hoc beatam me dicent omnes generationes, quia fecit mi magna qui potens est, et sanctam nomen eius, et misericordia eius a progenie in progenies, timentibus eum. Fecit potentiam in brachio suo, dispersit superbos mente cordis sui, deposuit potentes de sede, et exaltavit humiles, et surientes implevit bonis, et divites dimisit inanes, suscepit Israel puerum suum, recordatus misericordiae suae, sicut locutus est ad patres nostros, Abraham et semini eius in saecula. Gloria Patri et Filio, et Spiritui Sancto, sicut erat in principio, et nunc, et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
This is a reading from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 2, verses 1 and 3 through 7. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn.
Thank you. Hush by Lucinda Hynett. Shh. Can you hear it? An expectant silence, a hushed anticipation, as if the very galaxy is holding its breath. There are some truths even the stars know, like darkness, like loneliness, and how the night can be a living thing, and how once, long ago, the night waited in wonder, along with the darkness and the loneliness, for the sound of a baby's cry, for the miraculous to come down to the earth mundane.
In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph, and the child lying in the manger.
God rest you, merry gentlemen, let nothing you dismay, for Jesus Christ our Savior was born upon this day, to save us all from Satan's power when we were gone astray.
Reading from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 2, verses 1 through 12. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, asking, "Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews? For we observed his star at its rising and have come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, He inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophet. And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel." Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word, so that I may also go and pay him homage." When they had heard the king, they set out, and there, ahead of them, went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary and his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they left for their own country by another road.
Blessed chieftains, Late. That was no time for a child to be born, in a land in the crushing grip of Rome. Honor and truth were trampled to scorn, yet here did the Savior make his home. When is the time for love to be born? The inn is full on the planet Earth, and by a comet the sky is torn. Yet love still takes the risk of birth.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him, yet the world did not know him. He came unto his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, or of the will of the flesh, or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth.
We'll end this festival of lessons and carols with a blessing. May the Father, who has loved the eternal Son from before the foundation of the world, shed that love upon you, his children. Amen. May Christ, who by his incarnation gathered into one things earthly and heavenly, fill you with joy and peace. Amen. May the Holy Spirit, by whose overshadowing Mary became the God-bearer, give you grace to carry the good news of Christ. Amen. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen.
Wow, what a beautiful service of lessons and carols that was. I'm just so happy that we were able to put all that together and share it with you. Thanks so much for being a part of it. And please, if you're with us on Wednesday night and you haven't done so already, hop on over to gvmf.live, join our Zoom discussion with the performers. We can talk more about how this was put together and what kind of experience that you had. And then hope you'll join us next week on Wednesday, December 16, where we're going to be hearing holiday and winter solstice music from around the world, including Hanukkah music and some music by at least one or two of the people who've come to Greencastle for 3 summers to participate in the Silk Road Global Musician Workshop that DePauw and Gobin Church hosted. So that's going to be really cool. Then on December 23, we're going to have a kind of more secular Christmas cookie virtual sharing party along with a virtual Christmas carol sing-along. The way we share our Christmas cookies virtually is send photos and recipes to me at greencastlevmf@gmail.com, and I'll use as many Christmas cookie photos, and we'll put together a PDF little recipe book that we can share with each other. I think that'll be really fun. Then finally, on Wednesday, December 30th, Kathy Malik and friends are putting together a wonderful program of looking forward to the new year. So every Wednesday night, 7:30, be here if you want to watch the program together and discuss. And you can always watch the programs anytime on our Facebook page, on YouTube, and our website, greencastlemusic.org. Thank you again for being with us, and hope to see you soon and in the chat now. Bye.